than me. How two hearts can come together and love can last forever. But now that I have found you, I believe that a miracle has come when God sends a perfect one. Now gone are all my questions about why, and I've never been so sure of anything in my life. Oh, I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true. When God made you, he must have been thinking about me.
I promise that wherever you may go, wherever life may lead you, with all my heart I'll be there too. And from this moment on, I want
so sure of anything in my life. I wonder what God was thinking when he created you. I wonder if he knew everything I would need, because he made all my dreams come true.
You may be seated. Today we have all gathered in the presence of God to witness the joining of Danny Grabill and Cheryl Carrion in holy matrimony. From the dawn of human history, it has been customary for friends and family to witness the ceremonial vows promise between a man and a woman entering into marriage. If these solemn vows are kept faithfully, the blessings of God will follow. This is a special time of celebration that Danny and Cheryl will long remember, and because of this, they are very thankful that you have responded to their invitation and are here to share in their joy. But as grateful as Danny and Cheryl are to have your presence at their wedding ceremony today, they want each and every one of you to know that there is another wedding celebration coming one day that will be the greatest wedding ceremony ever witnessed in the history of mankind. And that will be when Jesus Christ returns to claim his bride, his glorious church, unto himself in the wedding to end all weddings. Danny and Cheryl want desperately to see all of you at that wedding, and they want you to know how you too can be a part of the beautiful bride of Christ. Quite simply, Jesus invites everyone, whosoever will, to receive his invitation to that final wedding by receiving him into your lives. The Bible is very clear about how all this is accomplished: by believing, receiving, and becoming. Let's take a look at believing first. The Bible tells us in the best known and most memorized verse, John 3:16, that God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believes on him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Believing in God means agreeing with him and accepting his word. His word tells us that we were all sinners, but that Jesus paid our penalty for that sin through his death on the cross. Then, 3 days later, he rose from the dead, proving that he truly is the Son of God and has the power to forgive sin. Now, once we believe that those things are true, we can then receive. Receiving Christ is as simple as agreeing with God that we have indeed committed sin against him and are all sinners. Then we simply ask him to forgive us of our sin, and we yield our lives to him and to his leadership. The truth is, there's not a single person ever born who has the ability to live their life to be like Jesus. And that's where becoming comes in. In 1 John 1:12, we are told that to whomever has received Jesus, to them he gives the power to become the sons of God, to all that believe on his name. We don't need to try to get our lives right before we can receive Christ, because no one has the ability to do that. Instead, God gives us the power, after we receive him, to become what he intended us to be. It's not by our might or by our power, but it's by his Spirit that we can live the life of Christ. So there you have it. Believe that Jesus is the Son of God, died for your sins, and rose from the dead. Receive him by confessing your sins and asking him to lead your life by his principles and promises as outlined in the Word of God. And then he will give you the power to become a child of God at the time that he enters your heart and life through your invitation for him to save you. Danny and Cheryl's plea is that if you've not yet done that, then you would consider making that decision today so that you might be a part of the unparalleled wedding of Christ to his glorious church. Let us pray. Heavenly Father, this is a very sacred and wonderful event that we're all getting to witness today. And my prayer, God, is that even as we've begun and started with the most important message that mankind has to hear, I pray you've already spoken and touched hearts and lives that, Father, may not have made that decision yet. May today be the day, God, when they drive the nail home to knowing that, Father, they can be a part of the greatest bride that has ever existed, the bride of Christ. And Lord, we long to see you come and to take us home unto yourself, where we can be with you forever and ever in a place called heaven. Father, I pray for these services and those that are here to witness it, that God, your blessing would be on this union. And Father, you would use this together for all of us to witness and to see the joining together of Danny and Cheryl. Lord, we love you and thank you for your grace and your wonderful mercy. And we ask these things in Jesus' name. Amen. There is a conscious effort that is essential in marriage, as there is to any activity that people engage in. This determination requires that we pay thoughtfulness to the little things as well as the big ones that are a part of the closeness of matrimony. Develop the capacity to forgive and forget and heal quarrels that happen. Say I love you and speak words of appreciation often. Do not come to take each other for granted and demonstrate your gratitude in thoughtful ways. Never grow too old to hold hands. Do not expect perfection of each other, for no human has the capacity for perfection. 1 Corinthians 13, 4 through 8, verse 13 says, love suffers long and is kind. Love does not parade itself and it is not puffed up. It does not behave rudely, does not seek its own, is not provoked, thinks no evil, does not rejoice in iniquity, but rejoices in the truth, bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never fails. And now abide faith, hope, and love. These three, but the greatest of these is love. Then 1 John 4:19 states, we love because he first loved us. Make your search for the good and the beautiful a common search. A good marriage evolves when two separate souls face life's pleasures and sadness, not necessarily in unison, but in harmony. God will lead you into such situations, and he will bless you and develop your character as you walk together, as Amos 3:3 suggests. May you ever serve him happily and faithfully together until you return to glory, or until at last one shall lay the other into his arms. And all this through Jesus Christ our Lord. And now Danny and Cheryl would like to each take a moment to share some personal vows from their heart to one another.
I never knew. That a woman like you existed. I gave up on that. But now I know that I have a Proverbs 31 woman. And I'm going to love you as 1 Corinthians 13 commands me to. When I first saw you, I knew. Give me your strength. I knew that God chose you for me. And I'm not standing in front of my bride alone, but my best friend. I have a front row seat at my best friend's wedding, but I'm also taking her to be my bride. I will love you the way Jesus loves us. When I gave up my singleness is when God looked down upon me and he was pleased with that and knew that he had you waiting for me. And I'm thankful for the trials that he's let me endure so I can stand here with you now. Changed my life. And you've inspired me to be a better man and to be a better follower of Christ. And when I look at your eyes, I see Jesus before I see Cheryl. And that's what I fell in love with. That's what I fell.
My dearest Danny, when I first met you, I was very content in my singleness, just simply going through the motions, focusing on what God would want me to focus on. I wasn't really looking, but as we got to know each other, I saw you the way God sees you. And the more I became closer to you, the more I realized I couldn't live without you. You became the air that I was breathing. It was like we were in sync every time we were together. But I knew that it was God that orchestrated this whole thing. We could have never done this by ourselves.
Amen.
And I will continue to walk with you and hold your hand just like I am right now. In ministry, in love, in truth. I am my beloved's, and he is mine forever and ever.
Danny, do you come before this gathering of friends and family to proclaim your love and devotion for Cheryl? Do you promise to respect her and to care for her during these times of joy and hardship? Do you commit yourself to share your feelings of happiness and sadness? Do you pledge to remain faithful only to her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Cheryl, do you come before this gathering of friends and family to proclaim your love and devotion for Danny? Do you promise to respect him and care for him during times of joy and hardship? Do you commit yourself to share your feelings of happiness and sadness? Do you pledge to remain faithful only to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Danny, do you have a token of love and commitment that you would like to share with Cheryl?
Yes, I do.
Then as you place the ring on her finger, please repeat after me. Cheryl, I give you this ring.
Cheryl, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
All that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Cheryl, do you have a token of love and commitment that you would like to share with Dan?
I do.
And as you place the ring on his finger, please repeat after me. Danny, I give you this ring.
Danny, I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my vow.
As a symbol of my vow.
And with all that I am.
And with all that I am.
And all that I have.
And all that I have.
I honor you.
I honor you.
In the name of the Father.
In the name of the Father.
The Son.
The Son.
And the Holy Spirit.
And the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
Before this gathering and before God, you have promised each other your love and have given each other rings to wear as a sign of your sacred commitment. Therefore, it is my distinct pleasure to declare that you are now husband and wife. Danny, you may kiss your bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you Mr. and Mrs. Danny and Cheryl Grabill. Reception held in their honor over at the bridge, and I want to go ahead right now, if I could, and just bless the food, and you're free to go over. Want to ask too, if you don't mind, let's clear out as quickly as we can, head towards the bridge, because the wedding party is going to come back in and take a few pictures. And what that means is the quicker you get out, they get their pictures in, the quicker everybody eats. That's wonderful, isn't it? So let's go ahead and have a word of prayer and we'll go out. Heavenly Father, thank you so much for the joyful celebration we've seen today. And Lord, thank you for those that have gotten to witness in it. And Lord, right now we want to bless their union. We want to ask for blessings on their union by you. And Lord, we want to ask that you would bless the food that we're all fixing to take part in just a moment. We love you, Lord, and thank you for these incredible occasions. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. God bless you. You're dismissed.